90s, 30s, and 40s dress patterns. And the TVA shop at MRT Media Lab is a really interesting place, and you can see that you have a dangerous tools around. But upstairs we also have like a sewing shop with like many items that Agnes is going to use to make dress. And you can maybe take a look at the most dangerous but most famous tools here, which is called a shop box. That's also paining me when we were trying to use it.
I love the shop box. Oh, yeah. I'm so fond of it.
It's an ancient tool.
So we're going fabric shopping, because Pinar has trained a neural network on a bunch of vintage photos of dresses, or vintage dress patterns, and it's come up with some really interesting dresses, and so we're going to have a try at making a few of them. So we've been through the photos it's generated and selected a few that we're interested in, and now we're going to try and make them. So right now we're getting some fabric to kind of think about what kind of stuff we might make them out of, and also maybe make some decisions about which dresses we make depending on what we find.
This is the Gather Here fabric shop in Cambridge, and as you can see, they have an amazing collection of fibers, fabric, and yarns.
Oh, this is a silk sandwich, so it's like 36 bucks a meter.
Oh, sure.
Yeah.
So how many meters do you think
We probably need like, oh, it's yards. We probably need 4-ish yards. It's good for. It's a shame we can't really do anything shiny.
So we found some nice fabrics, and Agnes is now working on some sketches that we will use for the dress. So Agnes is now working at the sewing shop at MIT Media Lab. This is a really cool shop with all the stuff that you need to make anything that you want. And she's been working on some designs since last night.
Like, this is a very cool shop with all this nice stuff. This is really cool because you can actually like measure the person, and you can adjust these accordingly.
So this is Pinar, and this is Pinar. Today
we are going to do one of the designs. So this is the design. I will also post it online, and this is the sketch that Agnes made.
Okay, so I'm gonna just.
So this is the pattern that Agnes came up with, inspired by the.
This thing gets inspired by your chest. So this is a very similar idea to the first one. The nicer thing about this is that it's much easier to layer, but you can still do the layering thing on there. So you can put, say, something like this underneath on the sleeve. There'll be some variant on, I think, like a straight dress top, just like almost like a vest, like just very simple kind of, very simple, like kind of nice form which is fitted to you, and then maybe I'll do that bit first, and then once we've got that, we can like add the skirt and then add the sleeves. And then in adding the sleeves, I was thinking as well of having like a couple of layers of pink and then a layer of red and then a layer of pink. Or maybe making them asymmetric, so you get kind of, maybe there's like 6 or 7 layers. And so you get different like bands of red and stuff like that. And then the skirt I think is pretty simple. I was thinking of doing just like a fishtail skirt, which is like a kind of tight fitting skirt, which comes like that. And with like a split at the back that wraps around your legs. This is not stretch.
So this will
sit hopefully really nicely. And then having like a skirt that sits over it that's a lot looser. And then I think what I'd do is I'd just stitch down the back and they'd like zip on together.
Will there be like ruffles on the skirt?
Could be, or,
Because it seems like there's some roughly. Texture
yeah, so
in the
it's
design.
It's like kind of a bit of a like prom dress meme at the minute. It's very in. The air's really got, so there's a bunch of like kind of ruffly prom dresses which have like a similar feel. I quite like the idea of having like a tight skirt under a ruffled top skirt.
It was a really, really interesting project, particularly because there was a lot of interpretation involved in going from the image of the dresses that came out, which were super, super low resolution, to actually making something that worked as like a functional item of clothing. So I'm wearing the thing that I made. This is kind of the more kind of odd looking dress. It was one of the pieces that the AA came up with. It was this kind of smooth, like quite angular black shape. And Ulf Pinard's dress was very, very different to something I would typically make. What I did when I was coming up with the designs was that I looked both at the kind of suggestions that EIO was making with shape and with form, and then looked at kind of designers who work with similar ideas. So when I was making Pinard's dress, there were a lot of kind of broader forms around the collar, around the sleeves, around the shoulders, and also around the hips. And so for that, I looked at a lot of kind of prom dresses and things that use like a peplum or a ruffle in how they're like structured. For the thing that I was working on that I'm wearing, I was looking more at designers who use this kind of angular shapes. So I was looking at a bit of Yoji Yamamoto. There's this wonderful hooded dress that Grace Jones wore. And kind of thinking about just how those shapes are integrated into different items of clothing. So yeah, there was a lot of steps of like interpretation between like going from this image to like looking at other designs and like kind of thinking about how those shapes could work and then like creating an item of clothing.
I collaborated with the AI to create some designs inspired by it, and I can say that it was a really fun experience, partly because when you first look at the AI-generated image, you don't actually see what kind of dress you are going to end up with. But when you start working on them, you start to see some patterns like fur details or pointy shoulders or ruffles and so on, and you start to say, okay, maybe a jumper with a pointy shoulder and some fur details might actually look interesting. And you take this inspiration from the AI, you add your own creativity and your knowledge in fashion to create something that you wouldn't create otherwise. And I think that's the beauty of it. And this is the collection that I created with inspiration from the AI by using the latest trends in fashion like fur and neon colors. And we are hoping to run a fashion show with the human AI collaborative dresses that we designed. And we invite everyone to participate in them.